fellow scientists, it's Justin again. You'll never guess what Mia and I just saw on the beach. Take a look. Isn't this creature bizarre? At first, I thought someone's ice cream had just melted on the sand, but Mia told me it's actually a blobfish, an animal that lives at the bottom of the ocean. You know, I've always been curious about the mysterious creatures that live deep beneath the waves, but looking at this blobfish makes me think, maybe there's a reason they stay hidden down there. What do you think, scientists? Why do deep ocean animals look so different from the animals we usually see near the surface? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to identify the zones of the ocean and describe their characteristics. Let's investigate! If you've ever been to the beach, you'll know that one of the most impressive things about the ocean is how it stretches all the way across the horizon. But the ocean isn't only huge on its surface. It's also unbelievably deep. Across the whole ocean, the average depth is about 12,000 feet. That's more than 2 miles. But the bottom of the ocean isn't smooth and flat. It's full of underwater mountains, valleys, and trenches. Some parts of the ocean go much, much deeper than 2 miles. The deepest place we know is called the Challenger Deep. It's almost 7 miles beneath the surface of the ocean. If you took Mount Everest, the tallest mountain on Earth, and placed it down at the Challenger Deep, the entire mountain would disappear underwater, and you'd still have more than a mile of water above its peak. In fact, the ocean is so huge that we actually haven't explored much of it. Scientists have mapped less than 30% of the ocean floor. There are still huge areas of the ocean that we've never seen before. To help us study all the mysteries hidden within the ocean's depths, scientists divide it into 3 zones: sunlight, twilight, and midnight. Sunlight, twilight, and midnight. Based on those names, what do you think scientists use to define the zones of the ocean? Light. Scientists divide the ocean into zones based on how far sunlight can travel beneath the surface. At the top is the sunlight zone, the brightest part of the ocean. The sunlight zone stretches from the ocean's surface down to about 650 feet. That's about the length of 2 football fields stacked end to end. The sunlight zone is the shallowest of the ocean zones, but 90% of all marine life lives here. Why do you think sea creatures would want to live in the sunlight zone? The sunlight zone is the warmest zone and the only part of the ocean with enough sunlight for plants to grow. These plants are very important because they create food and oxygen that many sea creatures need to survive. Tiny living things called plankton eat these plants. Small fish eat the plankton, and bigger fish and ocean animals eat the small fish. The sunlight zone is like a giant underwater cafeteria full of food for all kinds of ocean life. The sea creatures we see most often, like dolphins, sea turtles, and tons of colorful fish, live in the sunlight zone. But what happens when we go deeper, where the sunlight starts to fade? Just like the time between day and night, the twilight zone is the part of the ocean where the light becomes very dim. Only about 1% of sunlight reaches this area. That's barely enough to see by. This zone stretches from the bottom of the sunlight zone all the way down to around 3,300 feet. This is so deep that you could stack up 4 Burj Khalifas, the tallest building in the world, and they still wouldn't reach the bottom of the twilight zone. Imagine swimming deep into the twilight zone where only the tiniest bit of sunlight reaches. How do you think it would feel to be down there? The water gets colder, a lot colder. While the sunlight zone can be nice and warm, the twilight zone is chilly, with temperatures dropping to around 40 degrees Fahrenheit. You definitely want to pack a jacket, or probably a wetsuit. And it's not just cold, there's a lot of pressure down here too. The deeper you go, the heavier the water above you gets. All that water pressing down creates so much pressure that it could crush anything not built for it. The marine life living here have to have some special characteristics to survive these conditions. Take this Twilight Zone resident, the strawberry squid. What do you notice about its features that might help it live in the darkness? That's a pretty big eye. Its size allows in lots of light. Many animals in the Twilight Zone have big eyes to help them see in the gloom. What's even crazier about the strawberry squid, though, is the eye on the other side of its head is much smaller. The big eye lets in light from above, while the small eye looks down, watching for prey swimming in the darker water below. But what does it see down there? If the Twilight Zone seems dark and mysterious, just wait. Things get even darker as we dive down into the Midnight Zone. The Midnight Zone is the part of the ocean that no sunlight reaches, making it pitch black. It extends all the way down to the deepest parts of the ocean. The temperature drops even lower here, staying just above freezing. And the pressure is intense, hundreds of times greater than at the surface. It's like having the weight of 100 elephants pressing down on you. Some of the most unique looking creatures live in the Midnight Zone. What strategies might you use to survive in a world of total darkness? A flashlight might be a good idea. Many of the creatures who live here think so too. Some animals can actually make their own light. This is called bioluminescence. Like this anglerfish has a glowing lure that dangles from its head like a fishing pole. It uses this tiny light to attract curious prey. When a fish gets too close, snap, dinner is served. Other Midnight Zone residents have huge mouths and sharp teeth, so they're ready to grab anything that swims by. Some, like the gulper eel, have jaws so big they can swallow prey almost as large as themselves. When food is hard to find, you can't be picky. You eat whatever you can. Living in the Midnight Zone means finding creative ways to survive in the cold, dark, and high-pressure world of the deep ocean. Let's review everything we've learned today. The ocean is divided into three zones based on how much sunlight reaches them. The Sunlight Zone is where it's bright enough for plants to grow. It's warm and bright there. The Twilight Zone is much dimmer. Only about 1% of sunlight makes it this far. The water gets colder and the pressure increases. No light reaches the Midnight Zone, where it's pitch black, the water is near freezing, and the pressure is extreme. To learn more about the ocean zones, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. So, that blobfish we found made it all the way up here from the Midnight Zone of the ocean. Down there, there's a ton of pressure pushing on it to help the fish keep its shape, and it actually looks pretty normal. But up here, well, there's a reason they call it the blobfish. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time.